The solar flares generate showers of particles that can be extremely dangerous for astronauts. Also for astronauts on low orbit, like in the space stations. But in this case, they can be protected passively in shelters. What is more difficult to stop are the galactic cosmic rays, so the radiation, the charged particles arriving from our galaxy, that are particles, mainly protons, but also helium and heavier ions, with a very high kinetic energy. So the idea of a magnetic shield is not new. In the 60s, Wernher von Braun stated that superconductivity could be used to protect astronauts. But at that time, the technology was not enough developed for such a shield. The years after this statement from von Braun, a lot of people studied a possible magnetic shield, but all the studies were, let's say, academic studies, where only the magnetic field was considered, and no serious study involving also the materials, the magnet itself, the engineering, none of the studies were done. SR2S is the first deep study that considers not only the magnetic field, but also all the structure necessary to generate this magnetic field. We found that the more promising is the so-called PAM configuration, that is a multi-toroidal structure with a toroid in a non-axial configuration. You can see here at the center of the four toroids, there is a spacecraft, the module, the habitable module of the spacecraft. And these four magnets surround this module, protecting the astronauts with their magnetic field. Those are the simulation of the dose, the radiation dose to the astronauts, to the crew. In several cases, in black is the free space, the dose of an astronaut in free space. The second line shows the dose to an astronaut inside a Columbus module without any other shielding. And then the other lines show the shielding of different magnetic configurations. The arrow, puoi tornare indietro di una per favore? The arrow show the MT4 configuration, the pumping configuration, the one we showed before, with the magnetic field active. You can see that the dose is reduced to about 50%. This means that with such a shield, a trip to Mars became possible. So, for a conclusion, the SR2S project brings one of the most challenging magnet systems to be built. Various of the technology for such a space superconducting system do not exist yet, has to be developed. SR2S is an extraordinary technology development field and technology driver. We will see why. Active radiation shielding for exploration is a necessity. Passive shielding for galactic cosmic rays is not adequate, and for solar particles event can only protect limited volumes. Active magnetic shielding becomes effective at Haig we call BNDL, that means the magnetic field multiplied by the distance that the particles experience within the magnetic fields. And only if the material thickness traversed by the galactic cosmic ray is small. Why pumping configuration is important? Because there is a few materials around that generate the magnetic field. In a toroidal configuration, the material outside the magnet will interact with cosmic rays, generate neutrons that are not shielded by the magnetic field. We do not want neutrons, and so the pumping configuration is the right solution for this. SR2S has developed the basic tool for active shield analysis, started a systematic investigation, and achieved important technology developments. R&D path towards future development for light, high-field, modular toroidal shield design has been identified. Collaboration and synergy with NASA, ESA, and European Unit are active. And the perspective for application in physics, astrophysics, and medical science in space or on ground are a return of SR2S. Okay, and thank you. This is the end of Roberto's presentation.